Stop! Not another step or I shoot.
Wait. I have come on behalf of the Marquis de Lafayette.
He's taken an automat for his aide-de-camp. You're no more human than the machines that laid waste to this city.
I was not given the same orders as the others, monsieur.
Just what mission has the Marquis entrusted you with?
I must meet with Abbé Grégoire.
Alas, you've come too late. The abbot has got it into his head to go to the Palais de Justice. He is certain that Monseigneur de Lafare, the Bishop of Nancy, is being held prisoner by the monstrosity that is wreaking havoc on the Ile de la Cité. But how can he possibly hope to free him? The abbot is a holy man. He would lay down his life to right an injustice. But there isn't one among us who stands the slightest chance against that thing. Not the slightest chance.
The Palais de Justice.
You were made of neither flesh nor blood. You were an automat like those who committed this massacre.
I have received no such command. I am carrying out a mission on the orders of the Queen. Your friend on Place Saint-Marie informed me of your intentions.
Alas. I was not able to reach the Palais de Justice. I fear that the soul of Monseigneur de la Fare is lost forever.
Was he killed?
What has been done to him is a fate worse than death. Far worse. But I could go no further. There were so many bodies. So many innocents strewn about the square. The air there. There was something sinister about it. I felt it poisoning me, body and soul. As for getting back to the Société, it's hopeless. The streets are teeming with machines. But the machine that is wreaking havoc in the area around the Palais is colossal. Much, much larger than yourself. What's more, the soul of His Excellency the Bishop has been imprisoned within this monstrous machine. I'm certain of it. Have you seen the flames coming from the Palais? I don't think anyone...
I, Henri de la Fare, Bishop of Nancy, ask the Lord to bless this assembly and watch over this meeting of the Estates General. Let us not turn a blind eye to the misfortunes of a populace who is condemned to the most abject poverty, for there is no greater sin than to ignore the suffering of one's brethren. Wickedness of the court is an insult to the misery that reigns in our lands. In such dark times, how can one conceive of hiding away to play shepherdess or tinker with clockwork contraptions?
What happened? You stopped moving. I feared you had broken.
I do not know. I only touched this ring.
Monseigneur de la Fare's ring. Oh, to his son. Whoever you are, help him, please. Lord, let not that his soul be forever lost. Make haste, I beg of you.
All that remains is the massacre.
I beg you, leave this place and seek shelter. I have seen these machines in action. I know all too well their capabilities. I implore you for Namipa's shores! Stop! Seek to take heed my words. Flee!
We must leave this place, Monseigneur. There's no time.
Abbot! In God's name, save yourself!
Take this to the clerk's office at the Châtelet.
And I thought I was safe. No, no, no.
Be not afraid. I am not a member of the royal army. Au contraire, I intend to put an end to it.
And now comes the time when the wolves are at each other's throats.
I will not hurt you. You can believe me.
Believe you? I'm afraid it's too late, madame. Those whose bodies are strewn about this square paid the ultimate price for their blind trust. Like me, they believed in their country, in the National Guard that they were urged to join. They believed in the Marquis de Lafayette who was to lead them to victory, but they waited in vain for their savior. Look at them now. See what has become of their beautiful illusions.
How did they die?
Steel and fire, madame. We didn't stand a chance. And our wretched commanders must have known it. They saw what that gigantic automat was capable of, yet they let him cross the bridge and didn't sound the retreat. The only reason I'm still alive is that I'm a spineless coward. I couldn't help myself. My legs carried me here, where I hid, motionless. And it was from here that I witnessed the massacre. That creature, a parody of a cardinal, nothing could stop it. Soldiers and volunteers alike were mown down like sheaves of wheat.
The automat, does it have any weaknesses?
I don't know. My comrades attacked the sphere that supported it. In retrospect, they probably should have tried a different strategy. They should have aimed higher, perhaps, its head? If you could call it a head. There's no way of knowing.
I will go and find it.
A votre guise, madame. My prayers go with you, even if I don't think you stand much of a chance.
I will go and find it.
A votre guise, madame.
Thank you.
pro nobis peccatoribus nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Stay back!
Remain calm, Monseigneur. You are safe now.
What did they do to me? This dream. This nightmare.
What nightmare, Monseigneur?
It was terrible. I was but a shadow among shadows. There was so much anger, despair. How long has it been? A day? A year? Oh, fire! There were flames everywhere! And death! The suffering I was forced to inflict! Oh, Lord, what have I done? Is this the hell that awaits our immortal souls once our time on this earth has ended? If this is true, then how are we to go on living with nothing to hope for, nothing to believe in?
How were you captured, Monseigneur?
I was with Abbé Grégoire in Place Dauphine. We'd gone to speak with the volunteers of the Garde Nationale. We implored them not to take up arms against the king's machines. Alas, they refused to heed our words, and we had to leave in great haste. After that, mon Dieu, I can't remember a thing. Those poor people. These automats were truly made in the mold of their master. Ruthless! To think, for just one simple reproach against the court, the king cast me into hell.
You owe your freedom to Abbé Grégoire.
The good abbot, I tell you, this man is utterly irreplaceable. He has devoted himself, body and soul, to the mission I entrusted to him. Investigating the king's entourage. In particular, the man who enabled him to create this ungodly army. But, mon Dieu, the notes.
What notes, Monseigneur?
The notes the abbot placed in my safekeeping. Those heretics took them.
I know where the documents can be found. I must go to the Châtelet prison.
What shall I do? Where will I be safe?
Go and join the abbot at the Société des Amis des Noirs. The way is clear for now, but you must go quickly. More automats will be here soon. The Châtelet prison is at the other end of the Pont en Change. This grappling hook will be very useful.
We've got to get out of here quickly. We're in grave danger. These machines have neither heart nor mind. No mercy can be.
Thank you.
I must find something I can use to replace this lever.
Thank you.
Dieu soit loué. It is such a blessing to see you safe and sound.
This belongs to you.
Bless you, whoever you are. You have our eternal gratitude.
I believe you've met Monsieur Julien Raymond from distant Saint-Domingue. He's one of the most eminent members of our organization.
And you, Mademoiselle? What should we call you?
My name is Aegis.
Ah, yes. The Aegis. The mighty shield and scourge of Zeus.
I wonder. Earlier, by the Pont Neuf, when you touched Monseigneur's ring, can you explain what happened?
The ring called to me. It compelled me to reach out and take it.
Come now.
The moment I touched it, I was transported. Somewhere else. It was the same strange world that you were in, Monseigneur.
Hell, you mean?
Or purgatory.
I saw things there. I saw Monseigneur giving a sermon.
What wickedness is this?
This explains the moment when you froze. And this isn't the only time you've experienced something like this, Nespa?
That is correct. It also happened with two objects I found in Place Dauphine.
And what happened there?
That is where I found your Bible and your cross, Monseigneur.
How did you know they belonged to me?
They demanded to be returned to you. You did not regain consciousness until I did so.
This is madness.
Let us not be so quick to judge, Monseigneur.
I witnessed the moment when your cross was taken from you. Then I saw you being locked in that box.
Et bien voilà. It is just as I suspected. Here, Aegis, look at this. Over the course of my research, I unearthed this ancient document. I believe I have finally uncovered its meaning. It's a triangle with an identical inscription at each corner. Nemi, memory in ancient Greek. Then, in the center, there is an open eye which symbolizes awakening. Do you understand? The images you saw, Aegis, were Monseigneur de la Fare's own memories. Three echoes of the past tied to personal objects of his. Three Nemi's memories which some dark alchemy had taken from him. Without them, his mind would have remained lost, incomplete. He would never have regained consciousness. But by returning these three objects to him, Aegis, you were able to save his immortal soul.
Tell me, Aegis, when you were at the clerk's office at the Châtelet, did you perhaps see a leather wallet near the abbot's documents?
No, Monseigneur.
Ah, that is unfortunate. Most unfortunate.
Monseigneur, that other world where you were held prisoner, do you still feel its effects?
This other world, as you call it, Aegis, is none other than hell itself, Gehenna. The place the Lord sends those who worship the beast, but hell didn't keep me. Has God given me a chance to redeem myself, perhaps?
What task did you entrust to the abbot?
The Holy Office ordered me to keep an eye on the Comte de Cagliostro. This charlatan imagines himself to be the heir of Mesmer, the magnetizer, and seems to have ingratiated himself with the king. There have been disturbing reports about him that could lead to his excommunication. It is said that he can make the dead speak. Can you imagine? I asked the abbot to investigate the surroundings of Eugène de Vaucanson's workshop, where the Count had been seen coming and going for several weeks. I cannot disclose the details of what he discovered there, but it may well be related to the events that have plunged Paris into mourning.
Monseigneur, you visited the Marquis de Mirabeau to administer his last rites.
That's right. What of it?
Did he tell you anything about his son?
Please, not another word. I heard this man's confession, and am therefore bound by the strictest secrecy. There are no exceptions to canon law in this matter.
I bid you farewell, Monseigneur.
Wait just a moment, s'il vous plaît. You are one of Cagliostro's creatures, are you not?
What do you mean?
When did you awaken?
I do not understand, Monseigneur.
Well, that is to say, you talk, you think, you seem to act with some sort of free will. This was not always the case, that much is clear. You must agree that not all automates are as sophisticated as yourself. I'm attempting to unravel the mystery of your true nature. Tell me, what are your very first memories?
That is a question I am unable to answer.
How strange. In that case, you must surely be able to tell me who taught you what you know.
What I know, Monseigneur?
How can I put it in a way that you'll understand? For example, you call me Monseigneur. How do you know that this is how one addresses a member of the clergy of my rank?
I cannot explain it. I believe...
Go on, Aegis.
I believe that this knowledge is not mine.
Well, I never. Did you hear that, Abbot?
I caught every word, mon ami.
Mon père.
Plus tard, s'il vous plaît. I need a moment alone. I must read over my notes in light of what we have just discovered.
Monsieur Raymond, what is the aim of this organization?
We publish articles and exert our influence on those who are in a position to improve the lot of our unfortunate brethren. Our numbers grow by the day, and we have many illustrious members, such as the Comte de Mirabeau and the Marquis de Lafayette. But it was Monsieur Brissot and the Abbot that founded the group.
Good old Brissot. Shouldn't he be here by now?
Yes, mon père. He should have arrived hours ago. Alas, there has been no sign of him.
I hope to God that no misfortune has befallen him.
What fate does the kingdom reserve for those with black skin?
According to tradition, any enslaved person who sets foot on French soil is freed.
This rule is most problematic in the eyes of planters and the colonies, who would seek to maintain their precious labor force.
This is why, for the past 12 years, no black people have been allowed to disembark in any of the kingdom's ports. Those who accompany their masters on the journey are imprisoned in the Admiralty's jails the moment they leave the ship. As for those who manage to evade the authorities, they live in fear of the raids carried out by the Marshalsea.
Are you not subject to these laws, Monsieur Raymond?
I am fortunate enough to have been born a subject of the king through my father, and also to have received an education, and to be wealthy.
Naturally, that makes all the difference.
You are quite a long way from home, Monsieur Raymond.
I haven't been back to Saint-Domingue in nearly 5 years. I left my most trusted men in charge of overseeing my indigo plantation. I came to France with the aim of having an audience with the king. I hoped to convince him to use his automats for agricultural work. I was of the belief that this was the best way to ease the suffering of our enslaved brethren. Alas, it was all for naught. I was only able to get an audience with the Minister of the Navy, and even that was granted reluctantly. Later, when the King convened the Estates General, my hopes were renewed. I saw it as an opportunity to make our voices heard. And then, mon Dieu, what a disaster, Aegis. What a complete disaster.